More than 70 top medical specialists look set to quit over festering negotiations with Queensland Health. Their departure would close some of the state's most crucial surgical units.
It's a pile of resignation letters which could be about to send Queensland's health system into meltdown.
My colleagues don't want to go down this road, but they see no solution.
18 months after the visiting medical officer's last agreement expired, negotiations remain toxic.
It is not a question of money. This is a question of addressing standards in provincial city hospitals.
As an example, he says there are no urologists in Cairns, Toowoomba or Rockhampton, a symptom of Queensland Health's inability to train and retain staff. So it's come to this, and if they do walk out, the effect on services would be dramatic.
If entire units go away, it will place the system in absolute chaos.
Affected under the resignations in this pile from the Royal Brisbane, Gold Coast, Nambour and four other major hospitals are ENT, vascular and all breast cancer surgical units in the state.
That means women with breast cancer in this state who choose to access care publicly will not have specialists looking after them.
The VMOs insist they're not bluffing and they've set a two-week deadline for a deal to be reached. But the Health Minister says an agreement for 3-4% pay increases was already done.
The AMA had a good deal for visiting specialists, but they reneged on it.
That's not what's happened. We've been offered an ultimatum. Take this, like it or lump it.
They say indicative of the Health Department's disdain is a recent letter from the Minister addressed to Chris Davis, who hasn't been AMA President for 18 months. Max Futcher, 10 News.